Good afternoon. Welcome to Hendricks Chapel. Today we present music and message. This is a weekly series that features musical performances and spoken reflection from diverse religious and spiritual perspectives. We gather for music and message every Sunday afternoon at 4 p.m. throughout the academic year. And as we begin, I acknowledge with respect the Onondaga Nation, fire keepers of the Haudenosaunee, the indigenous people on whose ancestral lands Syracuse University now stands. My name is Brian Conkle. I serve as Dean of Hendricks Chapel, and thank you all for being with us today. Today we give thanks for those contributing to our program, which features new music for organ and choir. We give thanks for two students from the Settner School of Music in the College of Visual and Performing Arts here at Syracuse University, Dylan Kim and Noah Sherman, both of whom are composers whose works are receiving their first performances today. We also give thanks for the winners of the Hendricks Chapel Organ Commission competition, Ian Shaw and Ivan Borzicevic. My understanding is that these two awardees are joining us online today from the United Kingdom and Croatia, respectively, and we do welcome them and we congratulate them. Today, our performers include Azriel Davis, Owen Huckey, Alexander Metzler, Annie Laver, William Knuth, and of course the Hendricks Chapel Choir, led by Pepe Calvar. Our featured speaker for today is Natalie Draper, Assistant Professor of Theory and Composition at the Settner School of Music, and also coordinator of the Hendricks Chapel Organ Commission Competition. Thank you, Professor Draper, for being with us today. To all gathered with us, either in person or online, we do thank you for being with us. Our hope and our prayer is that music and message stirs hearts and minds that inspire us to sing during the storms of life. So as we begin, we do just that. All are invited to sing our opening song, which is the production of another commission competition held at the Eastman School of Music in 2019. This is Larry Visser's setting of Carl Dawes' hymn, Out of Silence, Music Rises. Please join in and please do enjoy.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Natalie Draper, and I'm an assistant professor of music composition and theory in the Suttner School of Music here at Syracuse University. To give you some background to this concert, in the fall of 2020, Ann Laver and I launched a one-day virtual organ festival entitled Composing for the Organ, Webinar and Concert. The purpose of this festival was to introduce composers to the organ and to also celebrate contemporary organ composition. The event included webinars, a composition workshop, and a virtual concert. This festival is only the beginning of what we hope will be a variety of future projects and initiatives to further encourage contemporary organ composition. One of these such initiatives is the first ever Hendricks Chapel Organ Composition Competition, which was announced in January of 2021. We received over 100 applications to this competition and were completely overwhelmed by the quality of the music we adjudicated. Today, we are very pleased to share with you the two winning pieces of this competition, Rivers of Eden by Ivan Bojicevich and Ian Shaw's Solomon and the Net. Both of these pieces demonstrate imaginative use of the organ, particularly when it comes to registral color, musical gesture, and form. These works are both world premieres, and as you know, this is a concert featuring four world premieres, including the works you've already heard by two students from our composition department, Noah Sherman and Dylan Kim. Noah and Dylan have been working with the organist to create these pieces, and we're extremely proud of these collaborations and look forward to seeing and hearing more new works for organ from our students. The world premiere itself is a big deal. You all are the first audience to hear these works performed live. For composers, this is also an especially important moment. We spend many hours, weeks, and months perfecting a piece on our own, working out the harmonies, rhythms, musical gestures, and structures. Unless we play the instrument ourselves, we rely very much on our imagination of how the piece will sound on the instrument performed by a pro. Very often, hearing it in person for the first time is a completely exhilarating and sometimes nerve-wracking experience, and this is particularly true on the organ, which is an instrument that can be felt in addition to being heard. So I would like to thank you all so much for being here to witness the debut of so much new music. The next two works will be performed by Syracuse University organist Ann Laver and Syracuse faculty member Alex Messler, respectively. So I'd like to welcome Ann Laver back to the stage. Thank you.
Solomon. Solomon and the gnat. A gnat came in from the garden and fields and called on Solomon for justice, saying, O Solomon, you extend your equity over demons and the sons of Adam and fairies. Fish and fowl dwell under the shelter of your justice. Where is the oppressed one whom your mercy has not sought? Grant me redress. Grant me redress, for I am much afflicted, being cut off from my garden and meadow haunts. Then Solomon replied, O seeker of redress, tell me from whom do you desire redress? Who is the oppressor who, puffed up with arrogance, has oppressed you and smitten your face? The gnat replied, He from whom I seek redress is the wind. 'Tis he who has emitted the smoke of oppression at me. Through his oppression I am in a grievous strait. Through him I drink booze with parched lips. Solomon replied to him, O sweet-voiced one, you must hear the command of God with all your heart. God has commanded me, saying, O dispenser of justice, never hear one party without the other. Till both parties come into the presence, the truth is never made plain to judge. When the wind heard the summons, it came swiftly, and the gnat instantly took flight. In like manner, the seekers of God's present seat, when God appears, those seekers vanish. Though that union is life eternal, yet at first, that life is annihilation.
Thank you. This blessing is called Equilibrium. It's written by
John O'Donohue. Please receive it. Like the joy of the sea coming home to shore, may the relief of laughter rinse through your soul. As the wind that loves to call things to dance, may your gravity be lightened by grace. Like the dignity of moonlight restoring the earth, may your thoughts incline with reverence and respect. As water takes whatever shape it is in, so free may you be about who you become. As silence smiles on the other side of what's said, may your sense of irony bring perspective. As time remains free of all that it frames, may your mind stay clear of all it names. May your prayer of listening deepen enough to hear in the depths the laughter of God.